The reserves pre-season is over. Let the competitive games begin. A place in the final of the Lancashire Senior Cup is up for grabs as Warren Joyce's side play host to Oldham.
In Yanazai curls one. Ball cut back and an easy tap in from Yanazai.
Disappointing end to the last edition of the competition saw the Reds dumped out at this semi-final stage by Rochdale.
It's Ian Henderson and makes no mistake. It's saved. Peter Vincenti and sends Rochdale through.
But win tonight and United will be one step closer to their 15th Lancashire Senior Cup title. Yes, the first game of the new campaign is a semi-final from last season. These United players looking to try and get through to the final of the Lancashire Senior Cup to take on Everton. In their way, an Oldham side with various players with league experience. So a good test for Warren Joyce's side tonight as they look to start their league title defence in a couple of weeks' time. We're at Leigh Sports Village in the semi-final of the Lancashire Senior Cup. It's Manchester United up against Oldham Athletic. Good to have your company. Former United and Oldham striker Andy Ritchie joins me in the commentary box for this one. Here are the two sides. Three changes to the side against Port Vale in the last of United's reserve pre-season friendlies. As I mentioned, great to see Sean Goss back in action tonight at this level for the first time since mid-December. He's part of a trio in the middle of the park. Matthew Willock will look to impress wearing 10. Scott McTominay through the middle up top as well. Competitive debut for Matthew on a Sunday on the right-hand side of the front three. And on the bench, Demi Mitchell, who scored a couple of goals in pre-season. Kieran O'Hara, Tyrell Warren, Tosin Kehinde and Callum Gribben, who was on target as well against Altrincham. Kehinde, who popped up with a couple of goals in those warm-up games. As for Oldham, well, they've had a miserable pre-season at first-team level without winning a game so far. They'll be looking to try and up the pace and up the quality tonight against this Manchester United side with a handful of players who have experience in the league and were mainstays in the Oldham team last season, including Carl Winchester, who wears 11 and will look to push forward down the left-hand side. Interesting to see Luke Woodland and Jake Cassidy in the Oldham side. Two players who've signed, one this summer, one last summer, both who've played United reserves many a time with their previous clubs, Bolton and Wolves, respectively. Referee tonight is from Blackpool, the team which United beat to get to this stage of the competition. David Underwood, the man with the whistle. With a hairstyle in keeping of the commentary team tonight of me, David Stowell, and former United and Oldham player Andy Ritchie.
There's no need for that, Dave. No need. But it'll be a test for the youngsters, especially with Jake Cassidy up front, big, strong. I've seen him a few times. He puts himself about, so it'll be interesting to see how the two lads at the back do in Regan Poole and Tuan Zebi.
This season's first game is a semi-final from last season. It might sound a little confusing, but the simple fact is win tonight and United will take on Everton in the final of the Lancashire Senior Cup. These two sides have gone head-to-head quite a few occasions recently in both the Lancashire Senior Cup and the Manchester Senior Cup. Last season, United won by 4-0 against Oldham. They have in the past won by as many as 7-0. But this is a much stronger Oldham side in terms of league experience than we've seen in the past against United's second string, so we'll see how the two sides measure up this evening. In the sunshine at Leigh, you don't see that very often, as Joe Riley closed down Jake Cassidy.
That was good covering, wasn't it? Because Cassidy was nearly through there.
Ball through here towards Darius Osai, one of the new signings for Oldham, one of the many new signings that Steve Robinson has managed to get over the line in this short pre-season for the Latics.
He's signed from Stalybridge Celtic, hasn't he? As a non-league, indeed, obviously.
Yeah.
But he looks a big lad. He looks as though he will put himself about as well. So they've got two physical players up front for Oldham.
Connor Brown looking to make something happen for Oldham here from this throw-in. Osai back to Brown, who pulled off the nutmeg, then went tumbling. And the referee says that is a foul from Axel Tuanzebe.
Yeah, it was a free kick. Good little nutmegs. Not sure that it hurt him as much as the shout, David, but it's something that the Manchester United back lads now have got to make sure that they...
Are we looking at a bit of zonal marking here, Andy?
I don't know whether it's zonal. I think that's just a horizontal line, isn't it? Or a vertical line. It's just they're not picking anybody up, really.
Midway through the first half. No shots on target so far. That's caused chaos, though. And that's certainly the best chance of the game so far. And it's fallen to Darius Osai.
Yeah. That was a strange setup from the Manchester United back four, lads. Just all stood there and... Nobody really took control of the situation. It was a missed header that Devontae Redmond should have got away, and it fell to Osai, and he was stretching that little bit. Thought it was a good chance. Could have ended up just underneath the bar, as it, you know, other than ending up just over the bar. That's really strange, the setup for that free kick from the Manchester United back lads, though.
They're in here behind United. Cassidy in the middle, there he is. Great block by Tuanzebe. Winchester goes down. A questionable challenge that by Sadiq El-Fatouri, but the referee was right on the spot and said no foul.
Well, I'm going to put my neck on the line, David. That's a penalty for me all day long. I don't know how the referee hasn't given that.
Here is Winchester, who might well feel that he should have won his side a spot kick there. We'll have a look at it in a second. Edmondson playing it, looking for Cassidy. Overrun a little bit by Regan Poole, and there is a foul, this time on clock. So a busy 60 seconds for David Underwood of Blackpool there.
Carl Winchester's having a go at the referee. I'm not sure what the referee saw. He's having a go about the penalty which he thought he should have had. That was the free kick.
So we'll get this free kick out of the way, and then we'll look at the...
And it was a free kick again, but I'm certain. I don't think I have to look at it again, David. I think it was a penalty.
Well, we'll make you have a look at it again in a second. let's do this free kick first, shall we? Clock is over it, and looks pretty interested in trying to test Dean Henderson here, but he only tests the four United players in the wall. So we'll see if anything comes of this Oldham attack. Throw to be taken by Callum Mantak. Osai up against Riley. It's out of play for a corner to Oldham. Who so far have looked the more threatening side, it must be said, with that penalty appeal, the couple of chances for Osai so far.
Well, there's a lot of experienced players in the Oldham side. And, you know, young United players just got to dig in a little bit, make sure that they compete.
George Edmondson, a late arrival into the penalty area there, spotted by Goss. In it comes. And it was Jake Cassidy who got above everybody there, but it took a touch off a United player on the way through. It'll be another corner.
Well, again, I don't see what the referees saw on there, because that has just gone out straight off Jake Cassidy's head.
Yeah, it didn't seem to touch anyone else on the way through, did it? But strange call. Let's see if it's an expensive one from a United point of view. In it comes, and the flick from Fain is behind and to safety from Dean Henderson's point of view. Let's have a look from the referee's point of view here. Is this a penalty?
Well, I've put my neck on the line. I think it's definitely a penalty. I think it's a penalty. I think he's caught him. I don't think he's caught him as much as I maybe thought at the beginning, but I think it's a penalty, me. I think there he just catches his knee, and I think the referee got that wrong, but United will be quite pleased with that.
He's done well here. Mantak got a good challenge in, and it will be a Manchester United corner.
They did really well there, Matty Willock. Was on his own, had to do it, but it was a good little layoff as well from Scott McTominay. Ball up to him, managed to get in, get his body in. Little flick with the outside of his right boot. And Matty Willock trying to just get in behind Mantak, just couldn't.
In comes the corner from Goss. Regan Poole is after it, so's McTominay. It is Poole who rescues it. It's a decent ball into the middle as well, and it's a goal! Out of nowhere, Oldham have dominated, but United have the opener. Matthew Olesunde, on his reserve debut, finds the back of the net with a flying strike.
How many times do we see this? Not in the game, not had a strike. Ball comes out. I mean, it was a bad corner again, too far. And it's a great ball in, and he does really well there, does Olesunde. Gets in the front of the defender. Great volley, keeper no chance. It's 1-0 United, and Warren Joyce will be sat on the sidelines thinking, how are we 1-0 up? And how? And I'm sure that Steve Robinson will be thinking the same thing. But a great finish from Matthew Olesunde.
To coin a phrase, football is a funny old game. United lead a game that they've barely been in terms of creating opportunities. Oldham will point to the penalty that wasn't given. But United have something to show for the first half. Maybe Cassidy can get his team on level terms. Just dragged the shot wide and offside gave up on it a little bit too early. And it has gone out for a Manchester United goal kick.
Well.
And that brings the first half to an end. The first half arguably in front of goal, dominated by Oldham. But it's Manchester United who have the lead thanks to a debut goal from Matthew Olesunde, who found a little bit of space and found a stinging shot to beat Chris Kettings in the Oldham goal. The visitors will still be wondering how they haven't had a penalty. All eyes went towards the referee, David Underwood, when Carl Winchester went to ground, but nothing was given, and United are smiling at the break as a result. The Reds lead by a goal to nil at half-time.
United are heading to Wembley.
United are FA Cup winners again.
Taking on champions Leicester in the Community Shield.
Money! History is made.
The Reds will be looking to impress the boss ahead of the Premier League kickoff. Join us for all your usual match day programming. Your day begins with a preview at 1, followed by Match Day Live at 3, Sunday on MUTV.
Heading back across, West Brom scrambling away, back in and in again from Paul Scholes.
Wayne Rooney is up. Paul Scholes, thank you very much.
Wayne Rooney. Rooney on the attack.
Oh, it's a lovely ball inflicted! 1-0, Paul Scholes!
Well, the number of times I've seen Wayne Rooney come in from the left-hand side and plant a little ball just at the far post.
This is Rooney, back to Nani. Great chance, wonderful tackle. Rooney with a second chance, and there's Scholes! What a story!
Wayne Rooney picks him out as well, knows where he is.
We'll be right back. now. Can Rooney get on the act as well?
Yes, he has.
Yes, he has. Another top-quality finish.
What a great little ball from Cristiano Ronaldo. High enough and low enough.
The officials.
Is Ronaldo. Good ball in. Rooney! Goal! Wayne Rooney!
He does tremendously well here. His pace and his quickness. And the cross in. It's to the far post and Wayne Rooney on his own.
Ronaldo. Berbatov waits in the centre. Oh, back to Rooney. Rooney onto his right foot. Oh, it's magic! Wayne Rooney, a fantastic goal.
Said earlier on, Steve, you're looking for a bit of magic from somewhere. You've got it here. You've got it here, the little back heel. And that's a pass into the net now.
Here's to you, the most important members of our team.
Kitty May King!
And it will be Willock and McTominay to get us going again. A change apiece at half-time. Most notable one, the United change, Kehinde on for the injured James Weir, who just hobbled off a little bit at half-time and has been replaced. Here's Redmond looking for McTominay, who's taken in his stride here. Lovely turn, the shot had power, and Redmond's follow-up wasn't quite as accurate.
Well, a good start from Manchester United, really good by Redmond. A fantastic burst through the middle and a good ball. Does really well there. McTominay just doesn't get enough curl on the ball to take it past the goalkeeper, Kettings. Just needs to get a bit more bend on that and it's in. But a really good start to the game. Good chance for Manchester United. Probably, you would say, should be 2-0 up there.
Scott McTominay just getting used to this centre-forward role in some ways, if you like. He played there a couple of times last season. More of a box-to-box midfielder, but certainly causing a nuisance at times up there tonight. Profiting from a good run from Redmond there, and now Kehinde looks for Willock. Support from Olusunde here. Goss and McTominay waiting in the middle. It's in from Alfaturi, and it's McTominay on the end of it. Just couldn't quite bend the leg enough to angle that goalwards.
Well, you've got to be pleased with the start, Warren Joyce, because they've had two chances now before Oldham have even got into their half, really, and caused any problems. Started a little bit brighter.
We've only played 3 minutes in the second half, but United have already had as many attempts in this second half as they did in the first. So an encouraging start to the second period after perhaps a little bit of a sleepy first half. I'm sure Warren will have made that point in the dressing room during half-time. Here's Osai. Towards Cassidy, lovely goal. Super header from Jake Cassidy. Oldham have the goal that their first half performance deserved.
Well, it's amazing, isn't it? Again, they've started really well. Probably should be 2-0 up. Don't get the goal, and then that's a really good ball from Osai. He did well to create the chance to get that ball in. Showed his strength yet again and showed his prowess with the ball at his feet, and a good looping header from Cassidy. He'll always do that. He'll be off the back, off the shoulder of the centre-backs and the full-backs, uses his height and his power, and that's a really good header. He's just guided it back right into the far corner. That's what you say when the ball comes across, head it back the way it came, and that's what Jake Cassidy did, and he's got his side back into it, 1-1.
Willock, good turn. Four players ahead of him in United red. Here's one of them, it's Elfatouri. Tries to pull it back for McTominay. And it's deflected wide. I think it may have been going wide anyway, but United will happily accept a corner.
Yeah, he's unfortunate. Another great burst down that right-hand side by Sadiq Elfatouri. It hits George Edmondson on the back. Might have been on target. It goes wide for a corner.
That's the end of the game for United's goal scorer, Matthew Olesunne, on his reserve competitive debut. And on comes the super sub, Demi Mitchell, who scored twice in pre-season from the bench. Let's see if he can repeat that feat tonight and get United to the final. In comes the corner from Goss, which gave Chris Kettings one or two things to think about. The reaction from the keeper said it all there. That could have been embarrassing for him, but he managed to keep it out. So Goss will go again. Options in the middle. Again, he finds the gloves of the keeper. It's Kehinde. And it could have gone anywhere, but it goes wide.
Yeah, keeper there trying to get a good two fists on it, but gets them the two fists on it, but doesn't really get a good two fist on it. Knocks it right up. Kehinde has the shot. And it just comes off of Poole's thigh and goes out for a goal kick. But the one before, he had to be pretty quick, did Chris Kettings. Otherwise, it might have been straight in from the corner.
30 seconds of the added time to play. Mitchell just left the ball behind, but he's won it back and he's found Gribbin. It's his kind of range. Oh, and it was very nearly his kind of goal. Just wouldn't dip quite enough, and that probably means we will head to penalties.
I think so, David. You can see what he's trying to do. Looks up very early, and that's what it's all that's in his mind. He thinks, yeah, I can get it on my left foot here. Takes it out, and a little bender into the top far right-hand corner, but just overcooks this year the ball at Gribbin. Really good to look and get that shot off as quick as he did, but was always going wide.
Referee is poised to blow the final whistle, and there it is. Strange old game this one tonight, really, because Oldham were the better team in the first half, but United scored. United the better team in the second half, but Oldham scored. It's always a slightly bizarre moment in a game like this when the full-time whistle goes and the fans get up and go to leave and then suddenly realise someone has to win this tonight, so they all quickly sit down again.
Yeah.
So penalty kicks to decide who goes through to the final. Manchester United to go first with Scott McTominay, who was the hero in the quarter-final. Looks to take a giant step towards the final, and it's saved. It's the best possible start to the shootout for Oldham. Jake Cassidy has already scored in the game. Oh, but he's made a mess of that. Sean Goss steps up looking to open the scoring in the shootout. And he does. Quality from him. United lead 1-0.
Very good penalty.
Connor Brown steps up for Oldham. And it's a cheeky penalty from a cheeky chappie.
Yeah.
1-1. Good from range. Devontae Redmond, what's he like from 12 yards? He's cool, he's calm, he's composed. And he has scored. Up he goes, and it's in.
Straight down the middle.
Chris Kettings once again trying to put him off. It is Poole, and it's in. Just.
Only just.
George Edmondson next up. And he makes no mistake, it's a quality penalty, and it's 3-3. Mitchell. Oh no! He tried to be clever, and it's gone wrong. Mantak with a chance to win it, and it's a chance he takes for the second season running. United are knocked out of this competition at the semi-final stage on penalties.
Matthew, a hard-fought game, a disappointing finish. What did you make of that?
Well, I thought it was a hard-fought game from our team, definitely. I think we battled well. I thought we stuck together as a team well. Unfortunate about the result, but we got to hold our heads up high for the season to come. So.
They were probably the stronger team in the first half, but you got the goal. Fabulous strike. Then United, the better team in the second half, but they got the goal. It's a funny game sometimes.
Yeah, I mean, that's football. It happens, you know. Sometimes the better team doesn't always get the result they want, but we definitely have to keep going on and hopefully look forward.
Well, such a disappointing way to end the game from a United point of view, but it was a strange night in general, wasn't it?
Yeah, the game went sort of in opposites, really, didn't it? Both teams were on top and didn't take advantage of it. And both teams scored against a run of play. But, you know, there's chances for both teams, especially Oldham in the first half. United were better in the second half, should have maybe had a couple of goals as well. Ended 1-1, and unfortunately the penalty shootout went the wrong way.
Indeed. Congratulations to Oldham. By the way, they play Everton in the final. For us, the run is over. But, Andy, thanks for your company.
Cheers, David.
Thank you for yours as well. We'll try again in the Lancashire Senior Cup. And, of course, we'll look forward to the league campaign with the reserves this season under Warren Joyce as well. See you soon. Bye-bye.
The new manager is here. And MUTV is the only place to see every minute of all his press conferences.
I can say that I am where I want to be. I want everything. I want to win matches. I want to play well. I have to say that I'm the manager of the biggest club.
Be the first to hear the facts from the man who makes the decisions.
The third player is already official or not yet? No.
Mourinho's press conference on MUTV.
Great legends, loved by the entire world. Pure passion.
He had fire in his heart. Who will be the next legend?
Foundation uses football to engage and inspire young people.
To help them build a better life for themselves and their community.
Engage. Inspire.
The Premier Prize.
In 1992, it was seen as a whole new ball game.
It is the Premier League finals on MUTV.
A breakaway league that United came to dominate.
Giggs, oh, it's a super ball, and Cantona is there where it matters.
He was the X factor that we needed.
We look back at key games with the players who were at the heart of the action.
100 miles an hour and constant tackle. These kids were a bit special. You'd much rather go into a last game of the season knowing that if you win the game, the title is yours.
It's the goal! The championship!
Boot in the face for my man, Pally here.
Bruce! Yes!
Thank God we had one centre-half who could head the ball anywhere.
The Premier League Files on MUTV. Yeah.